Have you ever heard about a creator called Niklas Christl? Well, if you haven't, highly recommend checking him out, but for today I want to talk about his titles and how we can recreate them in DaVinci Resolve. The first thing that you want to do in order to recreate Niklas Christl's titles is go to your effects library, go to titles and select this text plus title, drag it onto your timeline, select it. Go to the inspector in the top right corner, and next to this text plus you see this fusion icon, which I want you to click on. This will load up this whole animation in the fusion page, and right now we can start to customize our title. First of all, let's customize our text, and I'm just gonna go with your text, then change the font parameters, like go with bold, and then color. He uses only black and yellow. So I'm gonna select a nice yellow for our text, and then we wanna create a black box around our text. How we do this is we go to our shading tab in the inspector, select element number 2 and select enabled, and by default this is giving us a red outline. But what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go to properties and select this border fill and change the border fill level from character to line. And you'll immediately see that we have a red box around our text, and right now we can change this to black, something like that. So next step is that we're gonna add a drop shadow, because I believe he has that as well. So let's go to our template, hit shift spacebar and type in drop shadow, and just click on add, and you can immediately see that we have a nice drop shadow around our text box. So the next step is that we add a camera shake to make this a little bit more visually appealing. So let's hit shift spacebar once again and type in camera shake, and just select this camera shake and click on add. And if I hit play right now, by default this is like an earthquake and it's totally unusable with the default settings, so we're gonna change some settings in there. Oh, and by the way, if you don't have the time or the motivation to create your own video editing assets like titles, templates, whatever, highly recommend checking out MotionVFX, because they are basically a company providing video editing assets for DaVinci Resolve and Final Cut Pro X if you're into that as well. In my opinion, one of the best plugins for DaVinci Resolve, so highly recommend checking them out. Link is in the description down below. Lower my X deviation and my Y deviation to 0.004 or something like that. And I'm gonna lower my Y deviation to 0.002. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select my overall strength and lower this quite a bit. And then I'm gonna lower my speed just a little bit more. And if I hit play right now, you see that this looks way better than it looked before. Very nice floating text going from left to right. But if you wanna go just a little bit more up and down, you can always increase the Y deviation just a little bit. And of course, if you want the text to rotate a little bit, you can always increase the rotation deviation as well, something like that. And this looks something like this. So let's just lower the rotation just a little bit. And right now this looks pretty good to me. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this into frame and then bring this out of frame. And we're gonna do that by adding a transform node right after our camera shake, and go to frame number 10, select the keyframe on center, and then go to frame number 0 and drag this all the way to the left. Now go to frame number 110, set a keyframe on center X and Y at 0.5 once again, and then go to frame number 119 and bring this to the left out of frame. Our animation looks something like this, and now we want to smooth this out. So let's go to our transform and open up the spline window, select displacement, hit the zoom to fit button, highlight the first two keyframes, hit S on our keyboard, and now let's grab the upper handle and drag this over to the left just like so. And now we do this exact same thing with our second keyframes, and then bring this over to the left just like so. So this looks pretty much very good right now, but the camera shake on his titles will increase right before the title is about to leave the frame. So our title starts to leave the frame at frame 110. So let's go to frame 105 and keyframe all our parameters on the camera shake just like so, then move forward one frame and just increase the X deviation quite a bit, lower the rotation, up the overall strength and up the speed. something like that. And right now this should look pretty good. You can see that it speeds up quite a bit and then immediately leaves the frame. So this is it. This is how you would create the Niklas Christl title animations inside of DaVinci Resolve. That's a wrap, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already, to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to even more people that might be interested in that specific topic. But with that being said, guys, hope you all have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.